Yeah, Rick, it's not it's just starting to not look so good on us.
Exactly. And, you know, the longer we go, obviously, without this rain, then the more intense the drought can become. What's a good sign here is we're looking at our concho cam. Notice how the fields are fairly green still. We did have a fairly wet winter and spring, and things are just now starting to dry out. But 101, it doesn't take many days like that before you sap a lot of that moisture. 103 was the high temperature in Concho. We hit 101. It's currently 99, 101 in Stillwater right now. Hobart at 104. It's still 100. Blanchard, Norman, Midwest City, Edmond, and Guthrie. And, yes, if you're headed out this evening, expect very little change, just hot. We still have the heat advisory in effect the bulk of Oklahoma through the day tomorrow. Now, we may see some of this go away for the weekend as temperatures gradually come down just a bit. More on that in a second. This is the latest drought monitor from a couple of days ago. Notice that at least everyone in the state is in this area that we consider to be abnormally dry. Okay, that's not necessarily the drought. The drought kicks in at moderate, severe, extreme, and exceptional. Most that we have is extreme, and that's out in the panhandle. Let's compare this to what it looked like last year at this time, and look at that. We had exceptional drought covering the western quarter of the state. So if you compare it year to year, last year was much worse at this point. We don't want to see it get any worse, and we don't have any rain in the forecast, and that's the sad thing. We have lots of heat in the forecast, including this evening. Temperatures will fall from the 90s into the upper 80s by 11 p.m. We are going to see our temperatures go from triple-digit heat down to double-digit heat for the coming weekend. Temperatures dropping slowly, but it is still going to be temperatures above average. So it's not a refreshing cool down, just a slight cool down. Lows tonight, upper 60s, lower 70s. We're still going to hit 100 tomorrow here in the metro. 102 in Stillwater, Enid at 101, Alva 104, Seminole 100. But we're headed in the right direction. So your forecast for the metro tonight, 71 degrees under a clear sky. A south breeze tonight on into tomorrow, starting to pick up just a little bit. 8 o'clock temperature, 75, lunchtime 96, with a south wind of 10 to 20 miles per hour and a high of 100. We go on into Saturday. Look at this, 98, so that'll be the first day in a while we've actually had temperatures below 100. Still 100 or higher, northern and western portions of the state. Our heat dome, this is the big ridge of high pressure. Watch how it kind of continues to split into two and actually weaken. And at the same time, we get a little area of low pressure in Texas. What does all this mean for you? Just a drop in the temperatures. That's all it means. Doesn't mean any rain for us, unfortunately. We will hit 100 tomorrow. Then we see those temperatures come down just a little bit. And, you know, from 100 to 98 is not much of a drop, but we'll take it. 96 by Monday. 4th of July is Wednesday. Look for temperatures in the upper 90s with, as you see, no chance of rain the next 7 days. So that drought that is starting to creep back into the state will likely continue to intensify, at least for the time being.
I know a lot of people, though, are watching for July 4th already, trying to make those plans.
You bet. A lot of folks be out and about, hopefully at the lake.
Yeah.